Cupcakes, welcome back to my channel. So today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys a 4-year update while being on birth control. If you guys want to hear my thoughts, go ahead and keep on watching this video. Alrighty guys, so if you guys haven't watched my first video, I'll leave a link down below so you guys could pause this one and watch that one to see my initial reaction and what I've been experiencing first while being on birth control for the first time. But I just wanted to mention that I'll be throwing a little bit of experience while being on birth control and being diagnosed with PCOS and my side effects that I've had over the course of a few years while being on it. And I would suggest you guys going to a doctor if you guys are curious to learn more about birth control and any type of contraceptive for getting, you know, being protected. And I'm just going to be sharing with you guys my opinions and my experience, so I could only do that. And just a little disclaimer, I also wanted to mention that I've seen here on YouTube as well as on the TV that there is certain websites where you could order your birth controls from. I don't order mine through there. I just get a prescription from my doctor and I get refills at my local pharmacy. I'm not too sure how legit those websites could be. From what I've seen and what they advertise is like you could get free birth control or discounted birth control just mailed to you, and I would not suggest anyone to be doing that because it's always important for you to go to your doctor and actually get checked yearly because things could change, your body could change, and you never know what you have. Like, I didn't know I had PCOS, which is called polycystic ovarian syndrome. Basically, it means that I could grow cysts in my ovaries which could rupture. And with that, it causes infertility, it causes hormonal imbalance, it causes excess hair in places that we normally don't want hair to be grown, as well as weight management. I'm not too sure if I just said that, but I have PCOS and I've been taking birth control and I've been trying to take other vitamins to help with that. And with going on birth control, when I wanted to initially start it, they had to do a lot of blood work on me, and that's when they found out that I had PCOS. So that's why I suggest you guys going to a doctor and getting checked to see what kind of birth control you could be going on, because there's different types. There's the pill, which is I'm going to be talking about today, and the one I have is Sronix. I never changed it from the first video that you guys seen on my channel. They have the one that goes in the arm, they have a shot that you would go back every few months, and as well as the one that's vaginal. And I chose to take the pill because for me it's not hard to take a pill every day. I just put the alarm on my phone and I just take it the same time every day. Sometimes, you know, I miss and I'm maybe an hour late, but that's not really a big deal for me. I haven't seen much problems with that. And just a quick rundown, when I first started the birth control, because of my hormones being imbalanced and taking birth control was a lot of my body, I was just an emotional wreck. I was very moody sometimes, and some things I was just very sad, and you just didn't know what mood I would be in, especially going into work, which was kind of a problem because me and my old coworker at the time started birth control at the same time, and we're both like moody girls up in the front. So yeah, just something you guys should look out for is mood swings when you're first starting, because that's what I experienced. And over the course of years while being on birth control and having PCOS, I did have to get 3 ultrasounds done because I've experienced really bad sharp pains in my right side of my ovaries, and the doctors basically just wanted me to check to see if maybe I had some cysts growing there. And knock on wood, there were no cysts growing down there, so that's good. But till this day, I don't know the reason why I've had those sharp pains. And if you guys are experiencing any of that and you guys are afraid to, like, you know, hit up your doctor and tell them what's going on, don't be afraid. It's better to get things checked out and actually get an ultrasound done or whatever they suggest you doing. With being on birth control, I didn't really experience much weight gain even till this day. If anything, I know in my first video I mentioned that maybe I had dropped a few pounds, but since then my weight has fluctuated. I don't know if it's because of the PCOS, because sometimes if I'm really active and really dieting, I can like lose weight, and I also can gain it back really, really fast. And that's something that we need to keep in mind if you have PCOS, is you have to really take care of what you're putting in your body, because everything is internal when it comes to the whole PCOS and birth control, and like one little thing could like throw everything off. And I do want to mention that I also take multivitamins as well as the Alani New Balance, and that's supposed to help with hormonal balance as well as infertility and breakouts. I do want to mention that since going on birth control, my face had gotten really dry, because before I had really bad acne. I also shared this on that video that I would go and see a dermatologist where they would actually inject my face with steroids because my breakouts were like cystic acne. If you guys have been following me from the beginning of my YouTube journey, then you guys would see how my skin was way back over 10 years ago till now. Obviously, I have makeup on, so it's gonna look a little bit different, but my face cleared up when I first started taking birth control. But over the years, I don't know if my body just kind of got used to it. My breakouts during my period was minor compared to before not being on birth control. But since I've added the Alani New Balance, my skin is more normal than dry, and it's been helping with my breakouts during my monthly cycle. This is going to be my second month while taking Balance, and if you guys haven't seen my review of it, I'll leave a link down below of that as well. But honestly, nothing much has changed since being on the pill. The whole reason why I chose the pill was because it's just easier for me to do. I didn't want to get the shot because I know that it leaves like a really bad scar. And I noticed that I've watched Remy, which is another famous YouTuber here. She has PCOS and she got the shot, and for her, it just didn't work for her. So I wouldn't jump, I'm not saying that she jumped on the trend for like the shot. For some people, they just can't take a pill every day because they can't remember. But consult with your doctor to see what contraceptive would be best for you, whether it's the pill, the shot, I think this is called the depil, or the vaginal one. And because certain things, it would not work for you if you have different like stuff going on. Like how I have PCOS, it would not work well if it had the one in the arm. My doctor suggested giving me a low dose of oral contraceptive. So that's that. I don't plan on changing my birth control until I wean off of it. Eventually, in a few years, I do want to stop taking birth control because I don't want my body to be dependent on it. I do want to take care of my body naturally eventually, but I don't want to get pregnant right now, so that's the whole reason why I'm also on birth control. I know it kind of defeats the purpose because I also take the Alani New Balance, and that's supposed to help with fertility, but I mainly use the Balance to help with my hormonal part. But if you guys have any questions regarding the birth control I have, again, if you guys are wondering, I have the birth control Saronix, so you guys can tell that I'm on week 2 of being on birth control, well, for the month, and then I have one more week, and then these are sugar pills, which means that's when I'm supposed to be on my period. And since starting the birth control, I've had my period every month. I don't skip months unless I choose to, and I just go straight into a new pack. So that's one thing that I enjoy about being on birth control, is like, say I have a special event coming up and I don't really want my birth control, I just go straight into the next pack, which I don't suggest you guys doing because you could be like, you know, not balancing out your cycle, but sometimes I just do it. And I didn't really see too much problems with that. If anything, my flow has been the same since starting it. I've only had my period for 4 days instead of a week. So nothing much has changed since that first video 4 years ago, sharing you guys my experience, other than me having to go and get ultrasounds done 3 times because of a sharp pain. That wasn't the effect of the birth control. It was possibly because of my PCOS, but to this day, they don't know why I've experienced those sharp pains. And every now and then, I still experience them, and I just choose not to go and get a ultrasound down. If anything, I had one done, not 2020, but 2019, I had a ultrasound done because I was just constantly getting pain in my ovaries. And Alrighty guys, so that's going to be it for today's video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys have any questions regarding the birth control Strawnics that I've been talking about here in today's video, or about PCOS or anything in general about that, I know you guys really enjoyed my first video, so hopefully you guys enjoyed this one. If you guys have any questions or requests, please leave them in the comments down below in the comment section. If you guys haven't yet, subscribe to my channel so you guys are notified of future videos from me. Also click that bell, because apparently you need to click the bell to be notified. And if you guys enjoyed it and found this video helpful, give this video a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.